Hello, I'm Rob with a B, and this is 101 Ways to Make Fire. Last time, we spoke about the properties of wood, the physical properties of wood that make it suitable for making friction fires. I also showed you my hand crank drill and indulged in some gratuitous sexual innuendo with my lady friend, Roberta.
Oh, that's a big one.
Today we're going to find out which woods to use. In South Africa there are more than 1,000 species of indigenous tree, about 400 just in the area where I live, and that's excluding exotic trees, garden shrubs, all of that. Statistically, you're probably from a completely different part of the world. So instead of just recommending a whole list of species that are going to work, which you're probably not going to be able to find in your neck of the woods, I'm going to talk about the general properties that you're looking for in a timber which will make it suitable for lighting a friction fire. This is a piece of pinus patula. Yes, I said pinus. That's Latin for pine, specifically Mexican weeping pine, which is commonly planted commercially here in South Africa. This is an example of something that's not going to work. It is a resinous timber. The resin acts as a lubricant, and instead of forming an ember, the wood gets polished and buffed up, and it just doesn't work. It also has an obvious grain, which I hope you can see there. Generally, that's not what you want. You're looking for wood with a consistent texture. For the same reason, you want to avoid knots in your wood. This pine is very knotty. It is a knotty, knotty wood. What you are looking for is wood that is light, strong, and fibrous. This usually comes from a fast-growing plant, often something growing in disturbed areas with a high water table. Many of these will be primary or secondary vegetation, often called weeds. Okay, let's go and find some wood. Wrong way, it's that way. Okay, behind me is an old gravel pit where they took out fill material to build the road. That was probably 40 years ago, before my time, and we've been trying to rehabilitate it in the meantime, but it's still very much disturbed with a lot of alien invasive vegetation, which is a bad thing. But today it makes my job much easier, because that right there is what I'm looking for. Something called bugweed, or colloquially wild tobacco. I'm going to head down into the dong over here and try to find some dead wood. These things quite often get killed by passing felt fires. Whew, slippery. Ouch. Ow. Oh. Okay, this is a bad idea. All in the name of science. Balancing, fuck, I'm about to fall off. Whoa, slippery when wet. Remind me whose stupid idea this was.
Bloody hell.
Eat your heart out, Bear Grylls. Purple crested lurie. And while I'm here, I want to show you something else. Bracket fungus, otherwise known as tinder fungus. Maybe not the tinder fungus, but this is probably going to work instead of char cloth. So we're taking that with us. Home sweet home. Cheers. It was a good day's hunting. To the victor, the spoils.